always grown up in art and being inspired by art, and my father a musician, and my auntie's cousins are all artists. And when I was about 12, I had an art teacher that introduced me to Frida Kahlo and Van Gogh, and that was it. I knew that I wanted to be an artist. One of my earliest memories is of getting chalk and scratching it into a hard surface and just building up piles of dust, and just the texture of the dust. And it very much mimics my work now. Everything's about sculpture and about shade and colours, and I like things to exist and witnessing things exist and explosions of the meeting of different materials, that honesty. When I was 11, 12, I started using oil paint. This was an amazing medium, especially working with the sculptural aspects of my work. And I just fell in love with oil paint. Later on, at 21, I got a phone call from Casa Art, who owns one of the biggest art shops in the UK, and asked me to do a campaign with Winsor & Newton for 200ml artist quality paint, which was amazing, seeing as I've been using this oil paint since I was 11, 12. My cousin Lottie Childs is an amazing artist, and I always looked up to her, and I went with my father to see her end of year exhibition at St Martin. She was at St Martin, and the school looked incredible, and since then I got it into my head that I wanted to go to St Martin's. I got an unconditional offer, which was awesome. I had three jobs at university. I worked for Chelsea Football Club, worked in a pub that then exchanged into the Troubadour, and then I worked in the gallery. So I had a massive painting that I'd done in my foundation year called Pedney Beach, but it was my first strong, big painting, seascape. And I exhibited that in the front window of the Troubadour and got a lot of a reaction. And one of the people was Orlando Bloom. He saw the painting and really encouraged me and encouraged my work. And with the gallery, I got a solo show. My work's all about landscapes, about nature. I use nature as symbolism for how we're feeling, really truthfully how we're feeling, things that we can't describe into words, that we can describe into smells and colours and texture. Love is also a really important theme within my work. I use symbolism of animals, different species, how they engage with love and demonstrate love, and especially the swans. I've got a painting called The Lovers, that just when one swan dies, the other does as well. That's complete unconditional love. A lot of the paintings deal with the opposite of love. About 5-6 years ago, when I painted poppies, I really felt like I was doing something important. It really, really touched a nerve, the symbolism and the fragility of these poppies and how they represent life and the loss of life. And I think it's the perfect time now, because of the centenary, to explore that further, and a natural development for me. This exhibition is called The 11th Hour because the peace treaty for the First World War was signed on the 11th month, at the 11th day, at 11 o'clock. I think I definitely come from a generation that knows a lot less about the First World War than the last generation, and I think we need to pay our respects and we need to learn more and never forget. Through this exhibition, I want to say thank you to the people that have sacrificed their lives and continue to today.